Hello everyone, students. In our day-to-day life, we usually come across some situation which demands ethical and moral deliberations. Yes, sometimes even we struggle to make a proper decision or give a clear answer regarding right and wrong. It is not only with us. Each and every person encounters such ethical dilemma. So, in today's class, we will look into one such incident written in the form of poetry by Linda Pastan, and the name of the poem is Ethics. Before reading the poem, shall we look at the brief biography of the poet? Yes, Linda Pastan. She is an American poet. She was born on 27th May 1932 in Bronx, New York. She graduated from Radcliffe College. She has pursued her Master's of Arts from Brandeis University. She has many awards and honors to her credits. Pushcart Prize, Dylan Thomas Award, the Best Hawking Prize are few to name. She has written many books, namely Carnival Evening, The Last Uncle, Queen of Rainy Country, etc. At present, Linda Pastan resides in Potomac, Maryland. She has also served as a Poet Laureate of Maryland. This is a brief biography of the poet Linda Pastan. Before moving forward, let us look at some of the words which we will come across while reading the poem, the ethics. The first word, ethics. Ethics means moral values of human conduct. Drafty. Drafty, the word drafty means uncomfortable. Eschew, the word eschew means avoid. Rembrandt painting. So there is a reference to Rembrandt painting in the poem. Then who is Rembrandt? Rembrandt, he was a Dutch painter who was born on 15th July 1606 and died on 4th October 1669. Rembrandt was known for his self-portraits and biblical scenes. As you can see, the portrait of Rembrandt which is presented here is painted by Rembrandt himself. Yes? So these are some of the paintings painted by Rembrandt. You can see the artistic beauty in these pictures. Let's move forward and read the poem. Dear students, try to comprehend the poem as I am reading. So the title of the poem, Ethics. In ethics class, so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who had not many years left anyhow. Restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age, we would opt 1 year for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face, leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. 1 year, feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? Linda, the teacher would report, eschews the burdens of responsibility. This fall, in a real museum, I stand before a real Rembrandt, old woman, or nearly so myself. The colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter, the browns of earth. Though earth's most radiant elements burn through the canvas, I know now that woman and painting and season are almost one, and all beyond saving by children. So this is the poem written by Linda Passan. Let us analyze the poem and what the poet is trying to convey here. So students, when we read out the poem, we can identify that there are two time references in the poem. The first one is during the poet's childhood, and the second reference is at the present. Poem starts with the past reference, that is, so many years ago, and it takes its shift when the poet describes the present scenario. The shift is not only emphasis on the time, but also the maturity level of a child, particularly about the poet herself. Okay, so what is that important question on which the whole poem is narrated? Let's find out. The primary question asked by the teacher. In ethics class, so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who had not many years left anyhow? So remember, the teacher asked this question every autumn. Fall is nothing but the season autumn. And the word if refers that it is an imaginary situation. So what is the question then? If there were fire in the museum, what would you save? An old woman who would not live long, or an old painting preserved for centuries? Restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age, we would opt 1 year for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. Restless on hard chairs refers that the children were neither serious about the question nor comfortable to answer the same question which is repeatedly asked every fall, and also children lack knowledge of life as well as knowledge of art. That is why they are answering half-heartedly. 1 year, the children would choose life, and the next year, they choose art. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face, leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. But the poet Linda tried to connect the question to herself here, and she compares the old woman in the museum to her grandmother. She says that the woman borrowed the face of her grandmother, who for a time being left her kitchen and wandering in the uncomfortable imagined museum, which is completely unreal as the question itself. 1 year, feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? We can see that as the year passes by, the poet Linda is also aging, as well as she is being mature enough to give a diplomatic answer and avoid the responsibility of ethical decision making. Here, she leaves the choice to the old woman herself. This fall. Now, the poem's imagery is shifted to the present time period. Real museum, real Rembrandt, old woman, nearly myself. All these phrases refers to the reality of life. Due to aging, the poet has attained maturity. Yes, her attitude towards life has changed. The colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter, the browns of earth, though earth's most radiant elements burn through the canvas. Now the poet can understand the life as well as the value of painting. She has also gained the ability to make an ethical decision in complicated situations. In the final lines of the poem, we can see that Linda has recognized her inability to make a moral decision during childhood. But now she has understood the connection between the old woman, the painting, and the season. But still, she cannot answer the ethical question or the challenge. Rather, she goes beyond and says, "The woman and painting and season are almost one, and all beyond saving by children." So with this, we have discussed the poem, The Ethics, written by Linda Pastor. So after discussing, if we want to tell the summary or the key points of the poem, that would be: people make ethical decisions in their lives through personal experiences. So the experience of ones is very crucial in understanding ethical dilemma which we come across in our day-to-day life. The poet Linda Pastan emphasized on the difference in the moral decisions taken in young age and in old age in the poem The Ethics. The poem focuses on the relationship between values of human life and value of art. The poem also talks about the morality, the complex transitions of morality over time. So these are some of the key points which we can make out after reading the poem. I hope the poem is understandable, and students, please read the poem and enjoy the beauty of the poem.